your glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say.
So I just got to share with the guy. He has no idea who Jesus was. So I just got to introduce a bit of Jesus to him and share with him that we're going to be performing, singing and worshipping God. So yeah, he says he's going to stop by later. So praise the Lord, seed planted, the glory of God. Amen.
You are, Lord, I worship you.
That's one of the guys from the Swag family we're working together with tonight, just to feed the homeless. He's been up all night, and just thought I'll be a brother in Christ and lift him up to the Lord and pray that the Lord's strength be upon him to continue on to glorify the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what we come to do. You know, exhort the brethren, that's what the scripture says in Hebrews 10:25, and also in Timothy as well. So yeah, praise God.
Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. You see, you're Jehovah.
And also out here to help other churches feed the homeless, and physically and spiritually. Just met a man named Clive who was homeless, and he just shared a bit with me. And so I got to pray for him and through all trauma, and all the curses are broken in Jesus' name. But it's awesome because the joy of the Lord just came over him, and he has such a joy. And he's talking to one of the brothers right now, and it was awesome. I got to pray for him, and it's a blessing to meet people and go out there and share the gospel. Don't just sit on your bums on the pews on Sundays, but every day go out and tell somebody, share Jesus, preach Jesus.
That was one of the boys I used to play rugby with. He actually used to play rugby in the same age group as Luti. But I used to play with his older brother, and I got to minister, just share with him how the Lord's changed my life. I got to pray for him, and the Lord gave me a word of knowledge, and he was really touched. And that's what it is that it didn't come by word only, but it came by power. And it's the power of God that really touches people's hearts and changes people's hearts. That's what proves that Jesus Christ is alive. So all glory to Jesus, man. What a victorious day we're still going. God bless you.
Because of who you are, I give you praise.
G'day, guys.
It was awesome. We got to share with a guy preaching Jesus Christ from a father's point of view, and how it's just by faith. You're preaching that it doesn't matter how far he's fall back. It's just as simple as repenting, believing the gospel, moving forward. And we encourage him to go sin no more, and we encourage him how
If Jesus forgives our sins and iniquities, what gives us the right to look back and continue to remember what Jesus Christ has forgot? So that's an encouragement. When you move forward, forget the past, because Jesus Christ forgot the past. And yeah, go and see no more.
Well, I would just got to encourage him about being a father and bringing up the children, you know, nurture and admonition in the Lord.
Amen.
And that's what one thing us fathers need to do is bringing children up to the Lord, not to us ourselves, but to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because it's the source of everything. The only way the truth can work.
Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Hello, God bless you all. I was just talking to one of the sisters in Christ, and her name was Tony, and she's, you know, she's on fire. She says she's been walking 3 years with the Lord, and it's awesome to fellowship with her, and said she loved the passion, you know, and I said, praise God. And just edifying each other in the Lord. Even though they go to another church, but there's only one Christ, you know, one Jesus, one body, one Lord, one baptism. And, you know, I love to meet other Christians out there, and they're doing the same works as us. She stepped out of the church as well, because she said she was in religion. Until she stepped out, it's like, wow, now I'm growing now in the Lord. And I told her the same thing when I stepped out and started evangelizing, you know, feeding the homeless, whatever, praying for the sick, you know, see healings. And that's when you grow, like reality, not stuck in a building, but you know, we need to get out there. So that's what we're talking about. So praise the Lord, and you know, we'll worship God soon. So praise the Lord.
I worship you because of who you are. You see, you're Jehovah.
To share with him, Mia was sharing with him earlier, one of the sisters. I just came over and many problems. The thing that we shared with him was Jesus is the answer. The thing is, no matter how big the problem is, Jesus is way bigger than the problem. So all we got to share with him was Jesus Christ. We got to encourage him on what Jesus Christ can do to his life, and that Jesus can change him. But yeah, after we prayed for him, he got touched to the point that he started singing songs about Jesus Christ. And that's how free that the Lord made him. But yeah, it was awesome because just seeing the joy in him. When we were talking to him, he had a low countenance. But then after we prayed for him, a smile started to light up within his face. So yeah, the Lord, we believe the Lord's doing a work in him. And praise God.
You're reigning in victory, Jehovah Shalom. You're my Prince of Peace, a Yeshua.
Of the Lord is here to heal and to set people free, and we're here to proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord. And no matter what circumstance or situation, Jesus Christ remains Lord and will forever be Lord. Hell is hell because Jesus Christ is Lord, and heaven is heaven because Jesus Christ is Lord.
Jehovah Shalom. You're my Prince of Peace.
Hi. Just got to talk to Ellie, just got to share with her about the gospel of Jesus Christ, and just sharing with her how the Lord himself, in the flesh, he didn't own anything in this world, and how he just walked and he was content because he knew that the Father loved him. And I was just encouraging her just to talk to Jesus. And the only way that like, because she was saying she's a Christian, and I was just encouraging her, you know, when you say that you're a Christian, really walk in it and believe, and really need to know Jesus, because he's the only way, the truth, and the life, and no man can go to the Father but through him. And that he's there for her, and that all she needs to do is just seek him through the word of God. That's the only way that we can know Jesus Christ, is by the word of God, because that's the only truth. And just to keep seeking him, and that he will provide all her needs. Telling me about her daughter who has brain damage and stuff, so I just asked her if we can just pray for her, and she said, oh, she's already prayed, but because I had ministered to her a little bit just before, she was like, yeah, can you pray then? So I was like, oh, praise the Lord. So yeah, we just got to pray for her, and hopefully I know that when I see her next time, her daughter, she's gonna tell me her daughter's got no more brain damage. Praise the Lord.
Because of who you are, I give your glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of
who you are.
Hello, we're Just Jesus Ministry. We just had a divine appointment with one of the guys here, and we just got to share with him the love of Christ and the gospel, and that Jesus is the only way, no one else. It's not through denomination or through any other church or pastors or anything. It's only through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So that's it. And we got to pray for him, and I believe that he's here.
Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are. Because of
you got any fault?
No, man. No, it was awesome. We just met a fellow brother in Christ. He's truly watching and praying. He's sharing the gospel, sharing with people that the mark of beast is out, and he's just warning people freely. He's received, so freely he's giving as well, and it's awesome that we have fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus Christ sharing the gospel as well.
Yeah, I just came at the end, and what he was sharing was the system of this world is trying to run through bank cards and open cards and whatnot, and it's just sharing about the mark of the beast, which is read in Revelation. And, because of all men, rich and poor, to receive this mark. Our warning to you is, be careful that you be deceived. The Bible talks about, let no man deceive you. Let no one be found out of Christ and have a relationship with him. Jesus Christ is the only answer.
Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who
prophetic how the word talks about people being healed and still not believing God. I prayed for a man's legs to grow out just now in the name of Jesus Christ, and his back was healed instantly as his leg got healed. And I asked him, how do you feel? He says, he feels good. I said, that proves to you that God. He said, no. He started denying the whole healing part. But the thing that I'm trying to get out there is that a holding on period for the saints, those who are set free, is very important. Now is the holding on period. You need to hold on to Jesus. Many will see the miracles, many will hear about the love of Christ and still fall back. But for us, let's just hold on to Jesus. He used to be a believer, he used to walk with Christ. Sadly, he's bailed out. You know. But I praise the Lord that he's bailed me out.
Because of who you are, you see your Jehovah.
Met one of the homeless people, one of the homeless guys actually lived over here. This is the place that they call home. The most amazing thing was that he's grateful for what he's got, because he knows he's actually a Christian himself. He's still got some things to die to, but that's man, we leave that to the Lord. God's the one that does the changing, not people.
Amen.
So we just came here, just manifested the love of Christ, and he was really touched. Though he's never felt that kind of love before.
Yeah.
So, good. Amen. And one thing that we shared with him, even though he's homeless here, his treasure is stored up in heaven.
Amen.
So you set your affections on the things above, not the things on this earth. All these things will pass away, but the words of Jesus Christ will never pass away. So, yeah, glory to Jesus.
Amen. Yeah, it was really encouraging to see that he was grateful for what he had. A lot of people out there, they take what they have for granted.
Yeah,
that's why the scriptures talks about being content in things you have. And it's just an encouragement. Wherever you live or wherever you are, what you're in, it doesn't matter. Jesus Christ is bigger than any situation. So just pray to God, he'll help you. And he is our provider. And he gives you what you need and not what you want.
That's right. Amen.
God bless you. Jesus loves you.
Because of who you are, I give you glory.
Sets people up with people that they need to talk to. And my new brother in Christ, he had gone through something I went through. So separation in relationship and hurt and a broken heart. And one thing I was encouraging him is that Jesus Christ heals the broken heart.
Mm.
He molds you to be someone stronger than you were. And it's by following Jesus Christ and the Father's will that you will overcome. And I was just claiming stuff over his life, and we got to pray for him, and he gave his life to the Lord. He said that Jesus Christ is his heart. So thank you, Jesus, that obedience by his sons are made manifest, and people are able to give their life to Christ. It's so amazing. I can't explain. Angels are rejoicing in heaven because one sinner has repented. So, all glory to Jesus Christ. Repent, believe the gospel will come out of the world. Jesus Christ is our
friend. You're my prince of peace, and yes, you are. Yeah.
so we're out in the city and we're just preaching the gospel and just sharing the love of Jesus. I just prayed for one of the boys here. His name was Tyrone. He received Jesus into his heart, and it was amazing. He was really filled with the Holy Spirit. You could see that he was overwhelmed, so it was good to see. I remember that feeling when I felt that. It was good just to encourage him. I was encouraging him in the faith of Jesus Christ, just helping him to believe, read, pray, in constant fellowship. So everyone out there, please grow stronger in a relationship with Jesus. That's what it's all about. That's what we should be living for. So endure, soldiers, for the kingdom of God, in Jesus' name. Be blessed. Jehovah Shammah.
Now we're just encouraging one of the brothers in, I think, Swag Ministry. We're just encouraging him about the reality of being a Christian. That's what it's all about. Like. It's all about Jesus.
Amen.
It's not even about the church. The church should be thinking about Jesus. But just want to encourage all the brothers and sisters out. On, you know, serving the Lord, be real with God.
Amen.
Be real with people. And
It was good to meet him, another brother in the faith. We're just encouraging him and just sharing words with him and just encouraging him to endure the battle out there. It is a spiritual warfare. You must remain in the spirit at all times, and if you do fall, please do not condemn yourself. Repent and get up as fast as you can and fight the good fight of faith. So all you Christians out there, please be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might.
And one more thing is that we know that the scriptures talk about many members in one body. One thing that church needs to do now, the body of Christ needs to do now, is come in unity.
Yeah, amen.
Let's speak the same things. Let there be no divisions among us, and let's speak the same things and have the one mind, one judgment in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
We just got to meet a couple on the train. They just came from Carol's at the main. And so we got to share with them about what Just Jesus Ministry is about. We're just about Jesus, no one else. We believe in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and that they are one. So we do believe that. We got to do not be afraid to preach the gospel, no matter where you are. A Christian should be 24/7. It's not a part-time thing. You got to be full on fire for Jesus Christ, and that's what we are. We like to have joy in the Lord. It says to be as children, as you can see the children playing around.
God bless you guys.
They can't contain themselves. They have to have joy because Jesus is joyful.
Yeah, amen. In all things.
So yeah, we got to share about what Just Jesus Ministry is about. We're about preaching the gospel, laying hands on the sick, and believing that they will be healed through faith in Jesus Christ, through the name of Jesus Christ. So yeah, believe in the gospel. Anything you just want to say?
Love you.
Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you. All. And He's coming back.
Amen.
As you can see, all the beautiful faces. We're not about ourselves. Just so you can see a lot of this.
Yep. Glory to God.
Amen.